to our live studio audience and to our viewers at home. Snuggle close to your Yuletide fire for this nice viewing of the North Pole's Got Talent. We're gifted inhabitants of the North Pole looking for a special mystery prize. I'm your host, Holly Day.
I'm your host, Mrs. Tilmarin.
Ho, 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 Merry
Christmas. Up next, her hobbies include baking gingerbread cookies, caring for the reindeer, knitting holiday sweaters, and sewing teddy bears. Go for the loving, compassionate Mrs. Claus.
Have a seat, my dears.
A seat? A seat? None of us have time to take a seat. Why? We still have candy canes later. Not to mention those doll desks that need ironing. And the gift wrapping machine has been malfunctioning again, right? Oh, Mary. Mary, come out here.
Can someone help me, please?
Yeah, sure thing, Mary.
Is that you, Cole?
Yeah. Who else would they get to stage manage? That's right. Good old Cole. It's not like I have enough to do already, being in charge of the naughty and nice list. Do you know how many people there are in this world? 1.9 billion. That's right. 30% of the world's population. I'm supposed to be in charge of one-third of the world's population. I'm telling you, we really need to go digital. This whole writing things by hand is really getting to me. Talk about hand cramp.
Yeah, okay. Can you just please get me out of this?
So, the gift wrapping machine is malfunctioning, hand cramp?
Yeah. Can you help me?
Yeah, sure. Right this way, Mary.
Humorous banner. He's on useful ukulele to have around if you need a fashion tip. Give it up for the fashion forward Bond whose smile will warm even the coldest North Pole. Get Rudy the red-nosed reindeer.
Happy holidays! Great to be here tonight. So glad I could fit this into my calendar. Calendar? Get it?
Yeah, we get it, Rudy.
Oh, I thought the joke would slay. Yeah? Slay? Oh, how about this one? What do reindeer hang on their Christmas trees? Ornaments.
Good one, Rudy, but I'm pretty sure reindeers have antlers. Anyhow, moving on to our next contestant.
Oh, how about this one? What do Santa's elves do after school? They're gnome work. Gnome work. You know, gnome, kind of like an elf. Oh, how about this one? What do reindeers, elves study in school? The alphabet.
She really should be called Rudy, the bad one.
Sorry for my bad manners. I guess I'm just a rebel without a clause. You know, like Santa Claus. Oh, how rude off me. You get it? Rude off? Rude off?
We get it. Great. Now, judges, you're each going to get 12 cards. Cole!
Those cards are 12 drummers drumming, 11 pipers piping, 10 lords leaping, 9 ladies dancing, 8 maids milking, 7 swans swimming, 6 geese laying, 5 golden rings, 4 calling birds, 3 French hens, 2 turtle doves,
and a partridge and a pear tree. To review, 12 drummers drumming is the highest number of points you can give a group or a performer. A partridge and a pear tree is the lowest possible score.
Now Cole, can you please get our first contestant?
I'm on it.
Jingle, bell, you're up.
We'll also be playing our favorite instrument, and we'll also be singing our favorite song.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey! Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
So I really love the song Here Comes Santa Claus. It's so catchy.
My favorite song is Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, except for that heartbreaking part in the beginning where they make fun of his nose and don't let him join in any of the reindeer games. It's teary, I just think about it.
But what are your scores for Jingle Bell?
So much energy, so much energy and enthusiasm. I'm gonna have to give you 10 voids of weeping.
jingle, bell. I really love your performance, especially the whole jingly bell thing. So, but I just wanted to see more fashion, so I'm gonna have to give you just 9 ladies dancing.
And that is you, a total score of 30 points. Congratulations, Jingle Bell.
Thank you. So what? Merry Christmas!
Now comes along with the Christmas rhyme.
He gave a little nod and the chimney rolled out. I heard him proclaim as he flew out of sight,
Merry Christmas to all!
And to all a good night.
Alright, judges, what are your four characters?
Great subject matter. I'm personally going to have to give you 11 Piper's Piping.
I thought it was a great performance, but definitely not my favorite genre of music. So I'm going to have to give it 3 French hens.
I feel personally attacked and offended that you did not include Rudolph and your reindeer. I am a reindeer too, you know. I am in the front of that sleigh. Oh, I'm going to give you a partridge in a pear tree.
As far as the North Pole's Got Talent special telethon, we have heard from our several alumni who want to share why Anastasis is so special. Today, I'm interviewing Kip. Hi, thanks for so much calling, and I have a few questions for you to find out more about your perspectives on Anastasis. Kip, what's your favorite field trip you've been on?
Favorite field trip ever. Probably the sand dunes.
Nice. I like that one too. But what was your favorite subject in school?
I like math, just the way it challenges you.
What is the best school you've ever been to?
Well, Anastasis, obviously.
All right, nice. Good meeting with you, Kip.
Nice to see you too.
Wrap up. Thanks so much for calling a North Pole's Got Talent telethon and sharing what makes Anastasis so great. We miss your presence in our school, and we are so glad to check in with you. Folks, you've been seeing how much the school can change lives. Please donate online and support us during this fundraiser.
Be on the nice list this year. Make a donation to Anastasis Academy.
Jack, that's my name is Snow Queen. North Pole wouldn't be what it is without us. We should be led in this competition.
Jack Frost, you're the one that does all the beautiful patterns on the canvas, right?
Yes, I do. That's my talent. I know it's hard to believe, but every single crystal is different. They have to be individually crafted.
Why, just one snow crystal consists of over 1 quintillion molecules of water. The number of ways in which molecules can be arranged in a six-sided crystal is astronomical.
It's really an art form.
That's no small feat.
I've been perfecting my icicles lately, expanding just beyond the frost in the windows. Queenie here is fantastic at icicles, too.
How impressive.
Yes, we are impressive. The snow blizzard, sleet, frost, ice, and wind, we create this from the windows and others around you.
I suppose it's snow at frost glance. I could tell you were very chill. And I am one for frost impressions. Although I am not easily led to the wrong conclusions, I know that you are clearly destined for show business.
Does it really that
No! He's a judge.
Bird.
And we're here to win and take the prize.
Bird, Ivy, Spruce, these two aren't on the contestants list. Take these cold-hearted intruders away.
All right, let's get off the stage, nice and quiet. We don't want any trouble.
Why, there's no trouble at all.
Since we're considering them as contestants, what are your scores for the Snow King, Jack Frost, and the Snow Queen?
Well, nothing warms my heart more than having a sitting by the fire with a plate of milk and cookies surrounded by my loved ones. So I'm going to have to give you a 15-18 of milking.
Are you embarrassed of your dear old dad?
Can we talk about this later? This is a live television show.
It is? Philip, change the channel.
Mom, can you just make your pledge so I can take some more calls?
There you are, Pumpkin, we can see you.
You look so much nicer if you smile. Sweetheart, inside up straight.
Oh, right, I'm ending the call right now.
Don't forget to pick up some milk on the way home.
Who was your favorite teacher?
I would have to say Miss Wiseman, because she helped me through a lot and she just really connected with me and really, it felt like she really cared about me. And so, yeah.
Great choice. And what was your favorite experience?
My favorite experience? Huh. That's hard. I would have to say I really liked the religious pilgrimage that we did in Mr. Fink's class. That was really impactful.
Nice. And what was your favorite field trip?
Santa Barbara, probably, because it's just a great way to engage with all of your classmates and to get them to know them more. And just, it's a really great experience to help the homeless people and just amazing overall.
Well, great. You've seen how much this school can change lives. Please donate online to support us during this fundraiser.
Welcome to a group of holiday wrapping elves that always keep the upbeat holiday spirit from everyone. So, put your hands together for Mary, Joy, and Jolly from the stuffed animal patrol.
Season's greetings. Isn't this just wonderful? All these people here meant to celebrate the holiday season and can just feel the excitement and good vibes.
Merry Christmas. I'm Crazy Hank, Crazy Hank's used Christmas trees. Our deals on used Christmas trees are crazy. Our used tree lovers are so full of inventory this Christmas, we're practically giving them away. Just look at this model. Would you look at all those needles? Just spruce it up with a little green spray and be sure not to check it too much. And it's practically like new, and it can be yours for the low, low, no haggle price of $5. Next, we have a real wonder. A model that still has all its branches. She ain't no plunger, that's for sure. Just throw some tinsel and popcorn strings on that bad boy and you can have a real conversation piece for your living room. Just be sure not to get it too close to the candles. And for the low, low, no hogger price of $2, that bad boy could be yours. Next we have a classic. Yearning for the day's roar this Christmas, this here's the tree for you folks. This model's practically firewood. And yeah, drop it off the grill in the fireplace. But why would you do that? Who could do that to a classic? This is practically the Charlie Brown Christmas tree begging to be on display in your living room. is a real beauty. And it can be yours for just 50 cents. Just 50 cents. And wait, there's more. If you come this weekend, we have a special offer. Come this weekend, and you tell them Crazy Hank sent you, and you can get a free batch of cookies, including brownies from the Cookie Girls, sugar, sprinkles, ginger, and cookie. Good night.
As part of our North Pole's Got Talent special telethon, we have heard from several of our alumni who want to share why Anastasis is so special. Today I'm interviewing Riley. Hi, thanks so much for calling in. I have a few questions for you to find out more about your perspectives on Anastasis.
Awesome.
What was your favorite thing about Anastasis?
Oh, geez. It's really hard to pick just one. I love Anastasis. I think my favorite thing is more of what Anastasis taught me even after I left, as now I'm a senior in college. And still, I think often of how much my education changed because of Anastasis and how much now I love learning because it opened so many doors for me to be able to now have that perspective, even so many years later.
What was your favorite part of the day?
That's also so hard to pick just one. I believe when we used to do morning journals, which was time to have creative writing, and I've never had such direction with also flexibility of being able to learn. And so with that and so many discussions we had, it still impacted me to this day. And I talk about it with one of my friends that also went to Anastasis pretty often, actually.
That's cool. If you could change one thing about your experience at Anastasis, what would it be?
It would be that I would still be there and not have only been there the first few years it opened, because I think that it has just grown and developed in such beautiful ways, and I wish I could have been more a part of it.
Thank you so much for calling in North Pole's Got Talent Telethon and sharing what makes Anastasis so great. We miss your presence in our school and are so glad to check in with you.
Thank you. I miss you guys so much as well. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
dash your starting position during your track those hooves. All right, Cupid, let's show them what this holiday season is all about.
Hi, as a special part of our North Pole Got Talent special telethon, we have heard from several of our alumni who wants to share why Anastasis is so special. Today I'm interviewing Shane. And thank you so much, Shane. Okay. What do you think of Anastasis?
Well, I personally love Anastasis. I just love how family oriented it is and how much you feel at home when you walk into the building.
Okay. How did it help you grow?
It helped me grow in so many ways because my previous school, I really just didn't feel at home. And so just the different teachers and the different things we've learned throughout my time at Anastasis really helped me grow.
What is your favorite subject?
My favorite subject was all the inquiry-based things we did.
What was your goal at Anastasis?
My goal was to grow as a learner and really be prepared for high school.
Did you reach that goal?
I did. I'm doing very well at Lutheran High School.
Okay. What was your best field trip?
My best field trip was probably the Santa Barbara field trip with Mr. Fink. It was just very fun and very good to connect with the class in that way.
Okay. Well, thanks so much for calling into the North Pole Got Talent and sharing what makes Anastasis so great. We miss you at Anastasis and are so glad to check with you. Folks, you've seen how much this school have changed lives. Please donate online to support us during this fundraising.
Do we really need to check this list twice? Do you really believe in second chances? Do you really think he deserves a second chance? That kid is totally naughty. A lost cause for sure.
Come on now, Cole. Everyone deserves a second chance. Now, where are Ginger, Cookie, Sugar? Is this super secret surprise ready?
They nicely crushed beauty and all straight from the oven.
And a flooding ice cold frothy milk.
I tried to convince them to put sprinkles in, but they said no.
So, just what exactly is a super secret surprise?
Well, I tried to think of the best possible thing for tonight's prep.
So naturally, he thought of ginger snaps,
ice sugar cookies,
peppermint bark,
and milk.
Don't forget the sprinkles.
Cookies? That's the prize for tonight's competition?
Come think of it. Santa, a dose cookie.
Presents is your present. Now let's go to the kitchen to get these sure to be good cookies.
Wait, hold up. Jack Frost, knock, knock.
Who's there?
You log.
You log who?
If you log the door on me, I won't be able to get in. You log. You lock.
Ho, ho, ho. Right this way.
Don't you mean right this way?
A good one, Jack.
Watching North Pole Got Talent. As Ruby says, there's certainly no business like snow business. May your holidays be merry and bright.
Be sure to hang up those stockings with care. Have yourself a merry holiday season full of joy, laughter. I'm Mistletoe.
And I'm Holly. And we want to wish you
a merry Christmas.
All right, take five. This is Luke, the editor. I just want to say thank you for sticking to the end of the play. I just want to apologize for a lot of the parts. Our film crew aren't professionals. A lot of them, it was their first time filming something like this. So we had some problems getting clips in, so there might be some weird cuts, but I think it's okay for a play. And yeah, I just want to ask you to donate, please, to the fundraiser, because, well, it just helps support our community at Anastasis Academy to help do stuff like this. I just also want to give out a shout out to all the people that were in the play, the actors, and especially the film crew. It was kind of difficult, and it was their first time doing this, and we spent hours and hours working on it. But they stuck through, and it was amazing. It was a really fun experience. So I guess enjoy the bloopers.
As part of the North Pole Got Talent special telethon, we've heard from several of our alumni. And who wants to share how on the Anastasis is several of our alumni.
So judges, what will you give our Christmas
cut?
Christmas.
No, that's the puppet.
Tommy.
Yes, sir.
What? I'm filming it.
You're in.
Wait, kid? I'm in the bloopers.
Yeah, this got me in the blooper reel, dude.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Where do we go? There he is.
Say that part again. Okay. Whew. This is going to be hard. Slice. Okay.
Got this.
Luke can do it. I think it's Luke that's doing it.
He's like slicing over 200 cuts.